Welcome to the FixSleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. The Story of the Strange Wizard. Chapter 1. The Discovery. In the quaint village of Willowbrook, nestled amidst rolling hills and lush forests, there resided a wizard whose eccentricity was as legendary as his prowess in the arcane arts. Madrick was his name, known far and wide for his unconventional methods and his insatiable curiosity. His only companion in his solitary abode was Cleo, a sleek and cunning cat whose emerald eyes sparkled with intelligence. One brisk autumn morning, as the leaves danced in the gentle breeze, Madrick and Cleo set out on one of their frequent explorations of the surrounding wilderness. Their path led them deep into the heart of the ancient forest that bordered the village, where the trees whispered secrets of times long past. As they wandered deeper into the woods, Madrick's keen senses detected a subtle shift in the air, a faint tingling that hinted at the presence of powerful magic. Intrigued, he followed the sensation, his steps guided by an instinct honed through years of arcane study. After hours of meandering through the dense undergrowth, they stumbled upon a hidden glade bathed in dappled sunlight. Nestled within the glade was a gaping maw of darkness, a cave entrance obscured by tangled vines and moss-covered rocks. "Curious, isn't it, Cleo?" Madrick mused, his eyes gleaming with excitement. "I sense something of great significance within that cave. Shall we investigate?" Cleo regarded him with a knowing gaze, her tail swishing back and forth in silent agreement. With a flick of his wrist, Madrick conjured a ball of ethereal light, casting its glow into the cavernous depths. Together, they ventured into the darkness, their footsteps echoing off the walls of the cavern. The air grew heavy with the scent of damp earth and ancient secrets, sending shivers down Cleo's spine. Yet she remained steadfast at Madrick's side, her senses attuned to any hint of danger. As they delved deeper into the cavern, they stumbled upon a sight that took their breath away. A dusty old chest, adorned with intricate symbols of forgotten origin. Its surface shimmered with a faint magical aura, pulsating with an otherworldly glow. Madrick approached the chest with caution, his mind racing with possibilities. With trembling hands, he reached out to touch the weathered wood, feeling the hum of latent magic beneath his fingertips. "What do you make of this, Cleo?" he murmured, turning to his feline companion for guidance. Cleo regarded the chest with a calculating gaze, her whiskers twitching in contemplation. Sensing no immediate threat, she nodded in silent approval, urging Madrick to proceed. With a deep breath, Madrick summoned his courage and opened the chest, revealing its contents to the dim light of his conjured orb. Inside, nestled amidst a bed of velvet-lined silk, lay a parchment, a map, its surface adorned with cryptic runes and arcane sigils. Remarkable, Madrick whispered, his eyes alight with wonder. This must be no ordinary map. It radiates with the essence of ancient magic, a power long forgotten by the world above. Cleo padded closer to examine the map, her keen eyes scanning its surface for clues. As she traced the intricate lines and symbols, a sense of foreboding washed over her, a premonition of the perilous journey that lay ahead. Whatever lies at the end of this map, she said, her voice tinged with caution. It is bound to be fraught with danger. Are you certain we should pursue this, Madrick? Madrick met her gaze with unwavering determination, his heart pounding with the thrill of adventure. Fear not, Cleo, he replied, his voice tinged with excitement. For every danger, there is an opportunity to uncover the secrets of the past and unlock the mysteries of the present. Together, we shall embark on this journey, wherever it may lead us. And with that, Madrick rolled up the map and tucked it safely into the folds of his cloak, his mind already racing with plans and possibilities. Little did he know that their discovery would set into motion a chain of events that would forever alter the course of their lives. Chapter 2: The Journey Begins. With the map safely stowed away in Madrick's cloak, he and Cleo emerged from the depths of the cavern, their minds buzzing with anticipation for the adventure that lay ahead. As they stepped back into the warm embrace of the forest, the air seemed charged with an electric energy, as if the very trees were whispering secrets of the path that awaited them. Madrick unfurled the map once more, its surface illuminated by the soft glow of his conjured orb. The runes and symbols seemed to dance before their eyes, guiding their gaze to a series of intricate markings that indicated the first leg of their journey. A journey that would take them through treacherous swamps, enchanted woods, and shimmering lakes. According to the map, Madrick mused, tracing his finger along the winding path, our first destination lies beyond the whispering marshes, a land shrouded in mist and mystery. It is said that those who dare to venture into its depths are never seen again. Cleo's ears pricked up at the mention of the whispering marshes, her instincts tingling with a sense of foreboding. Yet, she remained resolute in her commitment to accompany Madrick on his quest, knowing that her loyalty and cunning would be invaluable assets in the trials to come. Then let us waste no time, my dear Cleo, Madrick declared, his voice ringing with determination. We shall venture forth into the unknown, armed with courage and curiosity as our guiding lights. And so, with a sense of purpose burning brightly within their hearts, Madrick and Cleo set out on their journey, their footsteps echoing through the dense undergrowth of the forest. The path before them was fraught with peril. Yet they faced each new challenge with unwavering resolve, knowing that their bond as companions would see them through even the darkest of times. Their first obstacle came in the form of the whispering marshes, a vast expanse of murky waters and tangled vegetation that seemed to stretch on for miles in every direction. As they ventured deeper into its mist-shrouded depths, the air grew thick with the eerie sound of whispered voices, their words distorted and incomprehensible. Cleo's eyes were searching the murky waters for any indication of danger, her senses on high alert. Abruptly, she noticed two bright eyes skulking below the surface. A dark beast, its shape hidden by the gloomy depths. "Madrick, look out," she cried, leaping to his side and conjuring a barrier of shimmering energy to ward off the creature's advances. Madrick reacted swiftly, his hands moving in a blur of motion as he summoned bolts of arcane lightning to strike the creature's hide. With a hiss of pain, the creature recoiled, retreating into the depths from whence it came. "Close call," Madrick muttered, his breath coming in ragged gasps as he surveyed the marshes for any further threats. "But we must remain vigilant. The whispering marshes are fraught with danger at every turn." With renewed determination, they pressed on, their hearts set on reaching the other side of the marshes before nightfall. Yet, with each step they took, the landscape seemed to shift and change, leading them deeper into the heart of the marshes and further from the safety of solid ground. Hours flew by in a whirl of frantic activity as they made their way through tangled thickets and hazardous bogs, with hidden perils and unseen impediments impeding them at every step. Nevertheless, Madrick and Cleo persevered in the face of insurmountable obstacles, their friendship becoming closer by the day. As night fell and the marshes were bathed in the pale light of the moon, they finally emerged from the tangled maze of vegetation, their bodies weary and their spirits tested, yet unbroken. Ahead lay the next leg of their journey, a dark and forbidding forest, its twisted branches reaching out like gnarled fingers to ensnare the unwary traveler. "We have come far, my dear Cleo," Madrick said, his voice tinged with exhaustion, yet filled with a sense of triumph. "But our journey is far from over. Ahead lies the Forest of Shadows, a place of ancient magic and untold dangers. Are you ready to face what lies ahead?" Cleo met his gaze with a steely determination, her emerald eyes gleaming with a fierce resolve. "I am ready, Madrick," she replied, her voice steady despite the weariness that weighed heavily upon her. "Together, we shall overcome whatever challenges await us in the Forest of Shadows and emerge victorious on the other side." And with that, they plunged headlong into the depths of the forest, their hearts set on the next stage of their epic journey. A journey that would test their courage, their strength, and their bond as companions like never before. Chapter 3, Trials and Tribulations. As Madrick and Cleo ventured deeper into the heart of the Forest of Shadows, they found themselves ensnared in a web of ancient enchantments and malevolent spirits. The air grew thick with the scent of decay, and the shadows seemed to dance and writhe with a life of their own, casting eerie shapes upon the forest floor. With each step they took, the forest seemed to come alive around them, its twisted branches reaching out like gnarled fingers to ensnare the unwary traveler. Yet, despite the oppressive atmosphere and the ever-present sense of danger, Madrick and Cleo pressed on, their determination unyielding in the face of adversity. Their journey through the forest was fraught with peril at every turn. They encountered creatures of nightmare and legend, werewolves prowling beneath the canopy, their eyes glowing with feral hunger, banshees wailing mournful dirges that chilled the very marrow in their bones, and shadowy spirits that flitted through the trees like wraiths in the night. But Madrick and Cleo were not so easily deterred. With each new challenge they faced, they stood side by side, their bond as companions growing stronger with each passing moment. Together, they weathered the storms that lashed at them from all sides, their courage unshaken in the face of overwhelming odds. As they journeyed deeper into the heart of the forest, they stumbled upon a clearing bathed in the soft glow of moonlight, a tranquil oasis amidst the chaos that surrounded them. There, nestled amidst the moss-covered rocks and ancient trees, they made camp for the night, their weary bodies grateful for the respite from their arduous journey. As they sat by the crackling fire, their thoughts turned to the trials they had faced and the challenges that lay ahead. Madrick gazed into the flickering flames, his mind awash with memories of battles won and lost, of friends and allies long gone. "We have come far, my dear Cleo," he said, his voice tinged with weariness, yet filled with a sense of pride. "But our journey is far from over. Ahead lies the Valley of Echoes, a place of ancient power and untold secrets. Are you ready to face what lies ahead?" Cleo met his gaze with a fierce determination, her emerald eyes burning with a fire that matched the flames of the fire. "I am ready, Madrick," she replied, her voice steady despite the exhaustion that weighed heavily upon her. "Together, we shall overcome whatever challenges await us in the Valley of Echoes and emerge victorious on the other side." And so, as the fire burned low and the night stretched out before them, Madrick and Cleo prepared themselves for the trials that awaited them in the days to come. Little did they know that their greatest challenges lay just beyond the horizon, waiting to test their courage, their strength, and their bond as companions like never before. As dawn broke over the horizon and the forest came alive with the sounds of waking creatures, Madrick and Cleo set out once more on their journey, their hearts set on the next stage of their epic adventure. For though the road ahead was fraught with danger and uncertainty, they knew that as long as they stood together, they would conquer whatever obstacles lay in their path and emerge triumphant on the other side. Chapter 4, The Final Confrontation. As Madrick and Cleo ventured deeper into the Valley of Echoes, they found themselves ensnared in a labyrinth of swirling mists and shifting shadows. The air was heavy with the weight of ancient magic, and the very ground beneath their feet seemed to pulse with a power both primordial and potent. With each step they took, the whispers of the valley grew louder, their words echoing through the dense fog like the tolling of a distant bell. Yet, despite the oppressive atmosphere and the ever-present sense of foreboding, Madrick and Cleo pressed on, their resolve unyielding in the face of adversity. Their journey through the valley was fraught with peril at every turn. They encountered spectral apparitions that flitted through the mists like phantoms in the night, their wails echoing through the darkness like mournful dirges. They navigated treacherous cliffs and bottomless chasms, their hearts pounding with the fear of what lay below. But Madrick and Cleo were not so easily deterred. With each new challenge they faced, they stood side by side, their bond as companions growing stronger with each passing moment. Together, they weathered the storms that raged around them, their courage unshaken in the face of overwhelming odds. As they journeyed deeper into the heart of the valley, they stumbled upon a clearing, bathed in the soft glow of moonlight, a tranquil oasis amidst the chaos that surrounded them. There, nestled amidst the ancient ruins and crumbling statues, they made camp for the night, their weary bodies grateful for the respite from their arduous journey. As they sat by the crackling fire, their thoughts turned to the trials they had faced and the challenges that lay ahead. Madrick gazed into the flickering flames, his mind awash with memories of battles won and lost, of friends and allies long gone. "We have come far, my dear Cleo," he said, his voice tinged with weariness, yet filled with a sense of determination. "But our journey is far from over. Ahead lies the Temple of Shadows, a place of ancient power and untold secrets. Are you ready to face what lies ahead?" Cleo met his gaze with a fierce determination, her emerald eyes burning with a fire that matched the flames of the fire. "I am ready, Madrick," she replied, her voice steady despite the exhaustion that weighed heavily upon her. "Together, we shall overcome whatever challenges await us in the Temple of Shadows and emerge victorious on the other side." And so, as the fire burned low and the night stretched out before them, Madrick and Cleo prepared themselves for the final confrontation that awaited them in the days to come. Little did they know that their greatest challenge lay just beyond the horizon, waiting to test their courage, their strength, and their bond as companions like never before. As dawn broke over the horizon, and the valley came alive with the sounds of waking creatures, Madrick and Cleo set out once more on their journey, their hearts set on the next stage of their epic adventure. For though the road ahead was fraught with danger and uncertainty, they knew that as long as they stood together, they would conquer whatever obstacles lay in their path and emerge triumphant on the other side.